What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Nurse Bass back with another video, back with the next installment in Mastering ABGs, paid for and sponsored by YouTube to not only help you guys begin mastering those ABGs, but to begin crushing those exams and to help you better take care of your patients.
Are you listening?
Nurse Bass. Beast mode.
In the previous video, I showed you guys the tic-tac-toe method, the primary method by which we use to solve ABG problems, to collect our data from our questions and to then interpret those ABG results. Now, in that last video, I gave you all straightforward questions. I gave you one that had a normal homeostatic person with normal blood pH and CO2 and bicarbonate, and then I gave you a couple that were very straightforward. Respiratory acidosis, respiratory alkalosis, metabolic acidosis, metabolic alkalosis, clean and clear cut. Unfortunately, in the real world, and also on your problems and your exams in the realm of academia, it's not always so clear cut. In the world of arterial blood gases, there's a little something called compensation. And what it is your body's attempt to compensate for these acidotic and alkalotic states. So think about it like this. You have a patient who's, and hopefully these numbers are beginning to get seared into your mind. You have a patient whose bicarbonate level is 10, let's say. Their bicarbonate level is 10. So, because they have less base, they are now in an acidotic state, okay? So, they are in metabolic acidosis. Easy enough. Our body's not going to just take that, so to speak. We're going to try to do something about it. And the way in which we do that is purely homeostatically, without even thinking about it, we begin to blow off more CO2. Our respiratory system takes over and begins to blow off more CO2 in an attempt to compensate for this acidosis, to blow off excess acid. Could even push us from a CO2 standpoint into a state of alkalosis. We could be blowing off more CO2 than what we would normally have. That 35 to 45, we could be blowing off more, but it's all in an attempt to bring that blood pH back into a normal range. On the other side of things, just to give you another example, you have a patient who is hyperventilating. They're blowing off all that CO2, pushing themselves into an alkalinic state, right? What our body might do then in order to try and compensate on the renal side, because there's a problem with the respiratory side, we can't fix it there, we're just blowing off too much CO2, how do our kidneys try and compensate? They stop producing so much bicarbonate. They allow more free hydrogen ions to be in the blood in an attempt to produce a more acidic environment to try and pull us out of that alkalinic state. To try and pull us away from an alkalinic blood pH and back toward a more homeostatic place. And so we see those kinds of things reflected in arterial blood gas results. You may, and I'm going to give you guys some examples in the next couple of videos, but you may have patients who have an altered blood pH, and then they also have altered CO2 and bicarbonate levels, both of which could be outside of their normal ranges. You'll see that on exams. It's just a means by which our body is attempting to compensate for this altered blood pH. And furthermore, it's broken down into two categories. One, our body's trying to compensate, but they're only partially compensating. Or two, our body is fully compensating. And there are very different presentations that you're going to see in these arterial blood gas questions. So it's important to understand what's going on. Okay, that's why I laid this video out the way I did. It's important to understand what's going on behind these numerical values, how our body's trying to compensate, Now what we're going to do in the next two videos is dive into interpreting these altered compensative results. It's your boy Nurse Bass, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video as we tackle some compensation problems. Peace.